make it over one lane, wait for this guy, put him up here, make it over another lane.
All right, so here's my bike, a Diamondback Honjo Comp. Originally a 20-speed bike, I converted it to 2-speed. You'll see I have a front derailleur and 2 chain rings on the front. So it's just 2-speed. And just a rear cog on the back, so just 1-speed on the back. So 2 times 1 is 2 speeds. Up front here, I have a thumb shifter using the Paul Thumbie. It's on the end of my Bullhorn. I have regular Bullhorn brake levers here. I went a little crazy with the bar tape. I brought the bar tape all the way to the center. I think I need to back it off a little bit. Whatever, personal preference. Fenders, studded tires today. It's 2017 and it's really cold outside. So let's get going. BikeBlogger here on my way to work. This is a little update video. It's been a while since I've done a video, or at least filmed a video, let's say. Last time I did a video, I fell off my bike. I had to get a bunch of stitches on my arm. Feeling better now. It is 2017. Got something different for you today. Got a shifter out here on my Bullhorn. Trying something a little different. See how we like it. Like shift down by pulling back right here. And now I just shifted to an easier gear. It's a friction shifter, so pretty easy to shift. You know, there's no indexing or anything, so it's really easy to set up. It's pretty cool, by the way. I'll give you maybe I'll add a clip at the beginning of this video showing you exactly what I did. But basically, I replaced the brake levers and added a thumb shifter.
Thumb shifter.
All right, here we go. Now that noise you're hearing are my studded tires. It is winter now. Upshift and push forward. Nice and smooth. I only got 2 gears because I just have a front derailleur on this bike. 2-speed bike. So what are my thoughts on this crazy setup? I mean, I have a pretty unique bike setup now. Trust that car is going to stop this stuff, right? I'm gonna do a future video about stop as yield. I think there's a case for it for cyclists. Anyway, what about this setup? This is really weird. I got Bullhorn handlebars. It's a 2-speed bike, not a fixie, not a single speed. Disc brakes, studded tires, fenders. Is it the ultimate commuter bike? It doesn't have a rack. You can strap bags to it though. I could put a rack on this bike. I've done that in the past. This shifter up here, this really works real nicely with a big glove like this. The Pearl Izumi Lobster Claw glove. Getting used to making turns with these studded tires. I'm a little anxious about falling. I don't want to fall again. So yeah, the shifter works really well with the big glove.
And it's a friction shifter, so you can trim it, you know, manually. So if it makes any noise, you can fix that. Hopefully you can hear my voice. These studded tires are sort of loud. Studded tires, if you don't know what they are, they're basically tires with spikes. So you're hearing metal grinding against the road surface. Should you use studded tires all winter, even when it's dry? Probably, yeah. Because there could always be a little spot with ice, and that's what they are for. They're not really for snow, they're for ice. But, yeah, you probably should. So what is the one thing I don't like about this setup? Well, obviously, since I have a shifter all the way out here, and it's, you know, sort of thrown together, you know, it's not, you know, integrated really. Yeah, I tried to make it as clean as possible, but you're gonna have a cable come out here. So it takes a little bit of space for where you grip the end of the bullhorn. But I guess the other thing is that my brake levers. Now, how are you gonna get a shifter on the end of a bullhorn aftermarket? There are shift brake levers, brifters, that exist. The only mechanical ones I know of are Shimano Metrea, which is a sort of new thing. I think it's only available in Europe right now. And there are, you know, some electronic sets, Durace and EPS, can't be so expensive, but you know, they do exist. So the only option really to get a shifter and brake lever next to each other on the end of a bullhorn is like what I got. Now, you could use an interrupter lever or a cross lever, whatever you call it, and then have a bar end shifter at the end of the bullhorn. Actually, let's go this way. Try not to get hit by a car. Oh, I just missed a line. I think I did. So this is where I fell. Right here. Sort of a steep hill. Alright, we're gonna stick to the right. Far right lane, we'll move over as we go downhill here. What I don't like, okay, yeah, I'm losing my train of thought here. Alright, what I don't like, get over. Make it over one lane. Wait for this guy. Put him up here. Make it over another lane. And now I'm gonna stick it one more time. Give my left turn lane. Now I'm gonna downshift. I'm gonna say the shifting is really smooth. I think that's just luck. I set it up pretty well. Or maybe it's experience. Or maybe it's both. Yeah, the only thing I don't like are these brake levers. Why? Well, because when you pull on the brake lever, it takes longer to connect to the brake pad and the rotor on the disc brake. What does that mean? That means these brake levers are not perfectly paired with my brakes, my brake calipers. What does that mean? That means I probably should not be using them. Why? Because what you want is good modulation. That is, you know, you want it to connect, but you want to, you know, be able to get some good, you know, good stopping power with not a whole lot of force, but also be able to modulate that up and down, which means brake harder or softer. not just hard or soft. So what I got going on now is it does break, but I have to pull the lever farther. Now that's because of the type of disc brakes I got. I got cyclocross brakes. They are TRP HYRD mechanically actuated hydraulic disc brakes. Ain't that a mouthful? My arm's hurting a little bit. Gotta take it a little easy. From that fall late last year. I mean, I'm braking just fine. And I'm, you know, the brake levers aren't hitting the bars or anything. But the last brake levers I had, they connected much sooner, but there was less modulation. These brake levers are meant for short pull brake calipers. It means the cable pull is not, you know, as long as like with a mountain bike. The brake levers I had before this were long pull. I gotta fix those brakes, it's just squeaky. Neither of them are really meant for these brakes. So what is the pull ratio on these brakes? Or these generation of these brakes I got, which are early generation. From what I've researched, the pull is sort of medium pull. So it's like in between, which from what I've read works perfect with, you know, like the Shimano 105 10 speed group set that came with this bike. And if I do remember, years ago when I had that on here, it did work well, I thought. The braking. I wasn't such a fan of the shifting. I'm riding a two-speed bike, so obviously I'm not a big, you know, fan of shifting at all. But right now, this is working out really well. Easy and hard, or somewhere in between. I've thought about, you know, getting a... Would that be a... Three chain rings in the front and two... Where am I going? Two cogs in the back, which would be what, three times two? I guess that's 6 feet. Maybe it'd be perfect for a commuter who doesn't live in a mountainous area. But anyway, with three chain rings, you can go real low or real high if you really wanted to, although there is a limit on that, I know. Depending on what your derailleur, your rear derailleur can handle. Anyway, I'm getting off topic. What do you think of my new setup? Bullhorns with a thumb shifter. Should I move the thumb shifter to the center of the bars so then I can grasp out here a little bit better? The whole point of this really for me though was I wanted the shifter near the brake lever. I've tried it before. Wasn't so much a fan of down tube shifters. And I am just a big fan of Bullhorn handlebars. So I've done a bar end shifter on at the end of a drop on a road handlebar. Wasn't such a fan of that. But again, you gotta reach away from the brake lever. I just like to have it all together. So anyway, I think that pretty much finishes this video. Again, an update video. I'm doing better. I'm not 100% supposed to be 100% soon. Maybe we'll talk about that in a future video. The road to recovery. Thanks for watching. See you around.